So I'm currently in France and I needed a break from Bali. I need to start traveling again. But let me tell you how it actually worked after living there for years. So I filmed this entire video once before, but I just found out that my car was full, so I gotta do it all over again. Bali is a small island located above Australia and under like China and Malaysia and stuff like that. It's a tiny little island in Indonesia. If you didn't know about it, it'll be really hard to find. Mainly the people there are Hindu and some of them are Muslim. You can find the Muslim people like usually in the north, like a Singaraja area. But mainly everybody you'll meet is like Hindu and they go hard on their religion. Some of the main things to do in Bali is go surfing, go hiking, do some spiritual stuff in like a boot. But yeah, I would say that surfing is really big there. Even if you don't surf, you'll probably get into surfing and hiking. You gotta do Mount Agung or like anything. It's like tons of trails and waterfalls all over the place. You gotta see it. Like some people I know come to Canggu and they come like party in like the main little city area-ish. And they never even go like adventure outside of Canggu, which is not the move. Like you have to get outside and go see what Bali has to offer. I say the best time to go to Bali is almost all year round, except for rainy season. Like rainy season ranges from like November-ish, December, January, sometime February-ish. But yeah, almost all year round is a great time to go visit. Getting around in Bali is pretty easy. You just rent a motorbike. They range from like $50 to like $200-$300 US. If you know the right people, you can get one for $50, which is around like 700K-ish. And they're pretty easy to find. They're like literally everywhere. But if you want those real prices, maybe go to Facebook Marketplace or like ask one of your friends how to get like one of those local deals. Don't just go straight for the ones that are on the street because they're gonna charge you way more. And if you want, you can step up to a car after you upgrade from a bike. You know, it's driving on the left side of the road, so it can be like just a little bit of time you need to get used to, but it's pretty easy to hang up if you know how to drive anywhere else in the world. And once you're driving, it's easy to get around because they use Google Maps. Do not use Apple Maps because you will get lost. Like a lot of Apple Maps isn't really updated in Indonesia, but Google Maps got you covered. Finding places to eat and drink is actually very easy in Bali. I made a video about like my favorite places in Bali. But yeah, it's tons of places. Like, I mean, like thousands and thousands of places. Everywhere you go, no matter where you're at, there's like food and drinks. Like some places I like to go drink is like a place called Morobito, which is on the beach, and the Brisa also in Canggu-ish area. Canggu is a great place to stay around because it's like where mainly everybody's at. I know a lot of people go over to Abu too, but I'm not that spiritual, so I like to just chill out in Canggu area or Uluwatu. In Uluwatu, you got a place called Ours that is pretty cool. You got Ulu Cliffhouse, Savaya, tons of places where you can go like hang out and just have a good time, you know. But yeah, the place I recommend to live is an area called Umalas, which is like a neighborhoodish area. It gives me a very like neighborhood suburban feel. And also an area called Pererenan. It's like right past Canggu and it's like dope. It's not so busy, it's not like super crowded like Seminyak or Canggu is, so I definitely recommend that. And do not stay in Kuta or Seminyak. It's not the vibe, I promise you. So just go over to like Canggu, Pererenan, Umalas, Uluwatu. Other than that, like I really wouldn't recommend that many places to live unless you like really like the nature and you can cook your own food or you get a chef. The chef is not that expensive either if they're not off for holidays, because the Balinese always are celebrating. They're always doing a ceremony, so you gotta like catch them at the right time. And while you're there, you definitely gotta get a glimpse into the culture. You gotta go around, you gotta get outside of like the touristy areas and go to the north and like Munduk. It's absolutely stunning up there. And even the east, like in Karangasem, they're like super traditional there and they do a lot of ceremonies that it's really cool to see. And also in Uluwatu at the Ulu temple, it's like this beautiful ceremony they do where they like dress up like gods and stuff like that and run around with fires. It's like one of those things you just have to see if you're coming to Bali and you can't miss it, you know. Oh. If you like this content, my name is Akil Wade. If you don't know me, I'll keep putting content out like this. And I have other videos where I recommend like the best foods and stuff like that. And if you need to, you need help looking for like a scooter or something like that, just reach out to me and I will plug some little links in the description that may can help you out on your Bali journey.